sitting beside me.
Hey, everybody. Big glad, show.
Glad you can come out on this another snowy day. That startup video there was by Riley Bertrand and Mike Newman. Thanks a lot. It's a Camry, and I believe it's going to Tweed. More information coming about Tweed later on in the video. Last time we got together, had a co-host here. Maybe not the last time, but
it was one of
it was one of the last times. But anyways, we're going to talk about summer. We did a Tear It Up Tuesday day one bash. So let's try to continue off where that went. We left off with Devin, got Mad Dog in his heat, which was so then on a Saturday morning, of course, we end up in the fairgrounds again, and of course, to go over to see Devin and Christy and all the Canadian lads and everything. So we had a little, Devin was kind enough to give us a little interview of him in the car on the Saturday morning. So take it away,
Devin. Well, we talked to you before in places, but where are we?
Cash for cash again.
And you're leaning against a car that's a little dinged up. What did you do last night?
We won the Mad Dog in the heat. Wrote the whole back end of the car off, front end still straight as nails.
Sweet. First Mad Dog here at Bash?
Back to back.
Back to back Mad Dogs.
And we're going to try to get another one in the future.
Sweet. Any big repairs today?
We have to do a little bit of wiring in the back, just tie it all together. The front, we're going to put repair plates on, even though it doesn't need it.
Last year, the front end was needed to pull down or something?
The front end was in about 8 inches on the passenger side last year.
So you got a little easier day.
Oh, it's a much easier repair this year.
That's awesome. Again, I say it to everybody. Any shout-outs to anybody, especially today with your help you're going to get and stuff?
Yeah, I got help. All the HF crew, the Mad Dog Motorsports crew, my dad.
Is that guy right there?
That's crew chief.
Right on. Super Dave.
All
I like
the guys out here helping, swinging the hammer, twisting wire, everybody.
Sweet.
And Melvin for being our special welder today.
Nice. I like that. Anyways, good luck tonight. And thank you. Again, tear it up and get her bent.
Thanks, Devin, for that time. I really appreciate that because, I mean, you're a busy guy and your crew is getting ready to go ahead and work on that car. The car looked pretty good
It was pretty good for being a Mad Dog, yeah.
Considering the year before, eh?
Yeah.
He had some damage up front, I think. So stay tuned for videos of Devin in the ring in the future and future episodes. But he allowed us to do something that I don't like to do with video, is film the car and the inside and close-ups. So I think we should show that?
I guess we could. He gave us permission.
He gave us permission, so... take it away.
Box I wouldn't have fucking paid that. How long have you got? I have no idea.
I don't care.
There's two more in this barrel. It starts at 3 year Kazi, right?
Yeah.
You probably got at least two.
Hey, Devin, can this stuff go up on YouTube after Bash is over?
Absolutely. Go whenever you want it.
No, it's not going up today. This is just for YouTube, but just let's see inside your car and stuff. That's all. Yeah. Okay. That's all.
This bag looks so nice. I had to come back.
Hey Devin, how many hours into this between everybody working on it? Average.
I don't know how many hours, but we've been building it off and on since February.
That was pretty cool seeing inside Devin's car. I mean, things changed, but it is what it is, and there's a lot of time and effort into those type of builds. Lots of time. I give Devin and his crew credit, and crew chief, his dad there. He does pretty good. Speaking of Bash and Canadians, who else did we run into that morning? It was kind of convenient.
Oh, we ran into, as we were talking to Devin and them.
Yeah, that's right.
Don Turner and the Patentists decided to drive by.
That's right. So, of course, I had to stop them. We had the camera out. So, did an interview with those guys. I think they're a little bit tipsy-turvy. They're having a good time. Bash is all about having a good time. But take it away, Kyle. Right.
Bash for Cash.
Wow.
2019.
First time for me here.
Third time for me.
Third time's a charm.
There you go. And who we got here?
Don Turner.
Kyle Patton.
What are you guys running?
80s wire class. Yeah. 99 Lincoln Town car.
Nice. One and done?
Yep.
Yeah.
Cool. You guys can't do this sport without help. I know that. Any shout-outs to anybody?
First of all, my wife, Nicole. Kyle Patton, and obviously his father, Will. Buddy Justin. AJ, when they can help. My sponsors would be Wayne's Tire, Gravener's Towing.
There you go.
And that's pretty much it. Mr. Transmission in Aurelia.
There you go.
Yeah.
And yourself, Kyle?
Well, first one, Tony.
Okay.
Just family, friends,
girlfriend. Cool.
Job scenes, how you're skipping work.
Yeah. I like that. Since you're a first time, I'm a first time, we're kind of soaking in. What
any wow factor yet? It's only like a half a day for me.
Just looking at the iron, like, it never ceases to amaze me. You see something different every year you come here. Yeah. Now they got the relic glass this year. That's cool.
Yeah, we've seen that live in San Francisco. That was
awesome. And we seem to be getting a lot more Canadians coming down, making the trip,
Yes. Which
is great.
Yeah, welcome to Facebook. And I didn't see stuff.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, it's just amazing to come down, get some decent parts for a reasonable price. When you're not buying them, obviously, from Fab Farm or R&R Derby products up in Canada. They're also another big contributor to what we do as well.
Yeah.
You know, Devin and Christy, they do a lot for the sport.
Freaking right they do.
You know, it's great that they have these people, right?
Yep. Yeah, sure.
You have to have them. I want to thank you personally
for
bringing it to Facebook world too.
Well, thank you. That's my thing. It's going to keep me in the sport because my driving days might be over in a couple months. I get the ultrasound.
Yeah.
You know, I've been telling the kid here, you know, like, I've been driving 35 plus years now. My first derby was when I was 12 years old in Graveners at the Winterfest.
Yeah.
And the body's just not taking it quite as much as it used to.
Exactly.
But I wanted to stay in the sport, so I'm helping out another promoter.
Nice.
And I'm trying to coach him as much as I can.
Without the youth?
Along with his dad.
Right. Like
his dad's been a well-known generation driver too, so.
Exactly. Without the youth, the sport's going to cease. And the youth seems to be there. So I want to support the youth as well because without them. Exactly. So anything wow factor for you?
Just the builds. It's crazy.
Just the builds. It's crazy. I've seen some wow stuff here.
Oh, yeah.
Man. Yeah, exactly.
See it on Facebook.
Yeah, it's not the same,
it's just not the same.
No, I agree.
Same as seeing it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But anyways, guys.
All right.
Tear it up.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Better bit, buddy.
All right.
Cool.
All right. Thanks a lot for the time. And again, be pictures and videos of those guys' cars coming up. Maybe I'll be keep rambling. I think Kyle ran in the
Street stock or something,
but here's a picture of his red and black Vic or something with a Chevy drivetrain probably. And Don, I believe, ran in almost the same type of class. There's many different classes
pro stock,
there.
Yeah, there's
pro stock or something, but here's a picture of Don's cars. We're rambling. They did pretty good. They had a good time. I mean, Don got hung up on the wall. You know, I mean, shit, luck. It happens. It happens. It is what it is. But Kyle got her bent.
Yeah.
He was bent in the front and in the back. He was having a good time.
That was a good time.
For his first run ever at Bash. That was pretty good. He was having a good time.
Decided to go for let's go for another tour and check out other
stuff. Oh, another golf cart ride.
Another golf cart ride.
Nice. Yes.
One of many.
One of many.
We're doing laps and laps, and we're driving. We see somebody that looks familiar, and who do we see? But we see promoter of Spinning Wheels, San Filippo, and Jeffy's Mini Meltdown, and Jeremy Gulley. So we decided to have a little chat with him.
That's right.
Good. Take it away, Jeremy.
Yep.
Cool. Well, where are we?
We are at in Chillicothe, Ohio, Bash for Cash.
And who am I talking to?
I'm Jeremy Gulley from Long Eddy, New York.
What else are you from?
What else am I from? Yeah. Spinning Wheels Productions.
Awesome, awesome. I like
Team
that.
Team Martin.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah.
Exactly. What are we standing beside?
Well, if you ever heard the Johnny Cash song, this Cash Car, this is about my Cash truck. It's a one-ton Dodge cab, 1960 cab. The frame is a 2007. 2007 Dodge 1500. The bed's a 97.8 Dakota.
Yeah.
Powered by a Diver Performance Engine 355 PH400 Corporate 14.
Oh, sweet, sweet. And it's a one and done heat.
It's a one and done heat.
That's only one pedal?
One pedal.
Nice, I like
the
that.
The one on the right.
I like that. You ran Bash before, I presume?
I ran 2 years ago in a 70 Wires.
70 Wires?
Yeah, that was an insane heat. And,
yeah.
We kind of been running the trucks for 5-6 years back home, pretty hard and heavy, and I talked a couple guys into coming out, and
we figured
we'd see what we can do.
Sweet. I'm looking forward to you running. You don't look like a rookie, so what was your first derby years ago?
My first derby was actually a fair that we just signed. Spinning Wheels just signed this year, Chenango County Fair.
Okay.
Back in 1994.
Yeah.
I ran a 78 four-door, six-cylinder rear-wheel drive Malibu G-body, and that was probably my best finish for like the next 20 years.
Hooked then?
I finished third. I was hooked before, man. I watched,
yeah.
I used to go as a little kid and watched Nancy Humphreys and Danny Menard and the whole Menard clan, and nobody in my family derbied.
Neither did my dad, yeah.
Nobody in my family did. I was a first-generation derbier. And kind of just did it on my own coming up through, you know?
Gotcha. Come here, Mike, for a second. Speaking of that, come around. Speaking of that,
this guy here was derby one day, and I was hooked. I watched him, and I was hooked since. That was way back in like what?
1995.
But speaking of that, you can't do derby without support or help. Yep. Any shout-outs, anybody?
Oh, well, Jason Diver, he's my go-to guy, my engine guy, but he's more than that to me. He's a real good friend. You know, if I got a question on a tranny or a question on that, Ski Inc. for their cradle, they do make awesome products.
Nice.
You know, and my wife is my number one, really.
Yeah,
you know,
we're all
without there. Her support, you ain't gonna get very far in either a marriage or the derby world, one or the other.
Exactly.
You get divorced, you can still derby or, you know.
Or
you don't derby and you have a happy marriage, one or the other, but she's always been there for me.
Pete.
You know, especially the last, it's been real tough the last couple of years.
Yeah.
You know, but we're still doing it.
Yeah.
And, we've cut down on shows, of course, because now we're promoting.
That's right. I was going to get into that.
Yep. So,
we got some this paint job on Facebook. Everybody's like, wow,
Brian Molino, we call him locally. I didn't even know his last name for years.
Okay.
We just know him as Hippie.
Hippie.
But Brian Molino on Facebook, he's a great dude. I hit him up, you know, a couple years ago, and I said, hey, man, I need a paint job. And things just didn't work out. Car didn't get done. And when we got this done, I hit him up again. And I actually took him the truck. It was painted purple. And I said, here's a blank canvas, brother. Do what you want.
Nice.
And I was, when I went to pick it up, he wouldn't send me any pictures.
No way. Yeah.
When I went to pick it up, this is what I seen. And I, you know, it kind of, it was just, I was speechless. I didn't know what to say. Man. I've never had a beautiful paint job like this. And I'm happy about it.
This is pretty looking good. So speaking of spinning wheels, you got some events coming up maybe?
Yeah, we got Mini Meltdown is the 15th of June. Yep, well, you get back to New York and you know, we've already got most of that planned out, ready to rip, but $4,000 to win compact show.
Sweet.
I think the total prize money is like $22,000, right around there.
That's awesome. You
know? We did it last year, had a real good turnout.
Yeah, we're
so
awesome.
We bumped up a couple of the prize monies a little bit. The drivers said they would like to get paid a little more deeper, so we went a little deeper, paid a little more. You know, that's at the Otsego County Fairgrounds, Morris, New York.
Gotcha, yeah.
Certainly come out and watch.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I know a lot of Canadians are coming down.
Oh, yeah, it's within reach of a lot of us in Ontario. Yeah. And the thing I liked about going to your event was I found it was a lot of fun.
What we're trying to do and accomplish in our area is bring the atmosphere like Ohio has, like Utah has. Utah is phenomenal, man.
Yeah,
you go out there and it's like, I mean, I remember 20 years ago when you started running, it was like, you know, you come and look at a guy's car and he'd want to fist fight you, you know?
Right.
So we're trying to bring that family atmosphere back a little bit. We're trying to bring the atmosphere of hey, I want to go to that derby because it's just so awesome. You know, guys beat the hell out of each other and get out shaking hands.
Right, absolutely.
You know, if you've never been to a New York derby, you know,
I
you don't know
that.
What you're in for. You know?
Oh, I spiel that to people when I talk to people at our local events. Come on down and check this out.
I had a lot of people came to our San Francisco Smash for the first time.
Oh yeah, that's what we did.
They're standing on the sidelines and the green flag drops, and 30 seconds later, people look, what the hell are these guys doing?
Right here. Yeah, we were like, wow.
There isn't a sandbagger one in the crowd.
I'm agreeing with that statement. But anything for this guy?
Yeah.
We're covering it up. I think so. Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, cool.
San Filippo 4 is October.
Yeah, there you go.
God, I'm going to get it on the 5th.
Something like that, yeah.
October 5th of this year.
Nice.
We're expecting over the 300 car mark again.
Wow, that was incredible.
And we're bringing back our relic class,
which
Tim and Russ called me and asked me if they could use our rules for here,
I remember you.
I'm just a derby driver, man.
Right.
And I wanted to give back to the drivers, and when we started it,
right?
You know, it was like it was just a way for me to give back to the local area. You know, and now for guys as big as Tim and Russ to call me and say, "Hey, man, we want to use your rules for a class." I'm like, I'm pretty flattered. You know, it's kind of humbling, but you know, mind blowing in the same sense that somebody wants to use my rules and run my class that we kind of started.
And you just nailed it about giving back, and it's just little things that I want to do, so I want to give you some of these things to give out to your crew.
Keychains,
some stickers for your young lad. Awesome, whatever.
I appreciate your time, man.
And we'll definitely
appreciate it.
We'll definitely see you this year.
We'll see you.
Yeah.
See you at San Filippo.
Yeah,
man, we'll be there.
Right on, man. Thanks for your time.
Yep.
Thanks, Jeremy, for the time. You're a busy man. I know you are, but great derbies. We love going down. We love going down to support you, and we love seeing all the stuff down there in New York so far that we've seen. There's a lot more to see, but we've only seen a couple, but we love it so far. Oh, yeah. I had to edit this in. We'll probably see you at Mini Meltdown, we hope.
Yep.
And we'll definitely see you at San Filippo Smash 5.
At San Filippo 5.
Guaranteed. All right. Well, yesterday was Saturday, January 25th, eh?
I believe so.
So they had a Winter Carnival out in Severn, Ontario, close to the Orillia area, eh?
Yeah, Gravenhurst area.
Gravenhurst area, eh? And they had a derby put on by Edge Motorsports. And there was 25 entries, and the weather was bad that day in Ontario.
Rain, snow,
everything. So yeah. Even for spectators, but even for the people to travel there with a car or vehicle to wreck was, you know, a deal, a hardship. But they got 25 entries that day, which is pretty good. Kyle Patton was entered, and of course there's pictures going by as we ramble. He won his heat, and he broke his tranny line off. So he didn't get to make it into the feature, but blah, blah, blah. He had a great time. 25 entries that day. Here's some random pictures got sent to me by Amy, his sister. I appreciate the pictures, by the way. Thanks a lot. Looks like a good time, and there was some spectators there. My phone here. Video clips will probably be up by Dan Hills and Zach McCormick. I heard they were there videotaping, so they'll be up in a couple of days. So I appreciate those guys for doing some video, because everybody wants to see some video at Derby. So that was the first Derby of a couple Derbies coming up by Edge. Let's just use our... There we go.
I know there's one coming up in Penetanguishene.
Penetanguishene, what do we got here? February 15th, yes. The class is there. That's been going on for a couple seasons now, Penetanguishene. Yeah. The classes, they say here on Don Turner's page, Figure 8 Racing. Stock mini and stock full size. They just added pro stock trucks, it says here, and the entry has to be paid, you know, by a certain date. But I mean, if you want to look it up, look up Edge Motorsports, all the information's there. That's on February 15th. Then on February 16th at the Gravenhurst Winter Carnival, that has been going on for a while. The 16th, so that's the next day. Wow, that's the next day. Again, classes, stock mini, stock full size, and stock minivans. Nothing like wrecking a minivan. Nothing like wrecking a minivan. So anyways, that's going to be a busy couple of days in February. And again, really appreciate Edge for putting on a couple of winter derbies. Everybody likes the derby thing. And to keep it going in the winter and keep it going all year round is pretty cool. It's not that far away from us, but it's out there. We've got our eyes and ears on Tweed on the 16th of...
February.
Oh, sorry, which is the same as Gravenhurst.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't. Geez, doing the calculations. It's the same. Yeah, it's the same day. That's right. So yeah, there is a Derby in Tweed, February 16th. The Winter Carnival is 14th, 15th, and 16th. And of course, I'll put a picture up here of the Winter Carnival sign. We're going to be running down there with a
Civic.
With a Honda Civic.
Honda Civic.
Four door.
Two door.
Two door.
It's an SI.
Nice. There we go. We got it cheap. We're going to use it. Having a fun time building it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm not in the shop.
It's a little different. Building it during the winter, because you know you're only limited for so much space. But you know, it was a car, and it's, you know, after a while you kind of get the withdrawal symptoms. So it's like, you know, this is kind of a fix, let's say.
Nice. I like that. I like how you're getting that done. And it's convenient that it was already black, eh?
It's already black. Yeah.
Can we put a picture up?
Sure, put a picture up.
All right, here it is. Two-door Honda Civic. Nothing special. We just want to get it built and get it wrecked, right?
Yep. Get it built. That's get
all.
It wrecked.
That's all we're doing.
Have some fun. Support the Winter Carnival.
There. That's all we're. That's right. Support and have fun. Exactly. That's what we're trying to do this year. And of course, we're talking about Tweed. Sent to me from people that are going to be running in Tweed, supposedly. And of course, they're all over the internet anyway, so of course I steal them. Somebody that sent us a startup video was Riley and Michael Newman out of the Renfrew area. It's a 94 Camry. And they did a whole motor swap. They took the V6 out, I guess, put it in the snowbank, and did a cradle swap and everything. And they're going to have a good time down in Tweed. Last year he was there.
Yep.
Had a good time. They did half decent, so that's cool. Thanks for coming out and supporting. Another person who's coming down with a car maybe is a Gerald Keller out of Bancroft. He ran this 2006 Pontiac G6 twice, or I think, I know he was in Madoc with it, and somewhere close to Bancroft was his first time. I can't remember the name. It was a, anyways, I know it was ran twice. He had some bad luck in both of them. Madoc he did okay, but he hopes to finish it off in Tweed, so hopefully you make it, Gerald. I really appreciate it if you do, and thanks for sending the picture in. Trucks. Another local guy kind of to us is going to be running
Brian
at Renfrew.
Brian
Cunningham. You keep saying LS Nation, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, so he posts pictures of that, so of course they're going up here because they're on the public internet, so hopefully you make it down, Brian. Last year was only 3 trucks, so it'd be kind of cool if there's more than 3 this year. Another one that looks like he might be coming is a Steve LeMay out of Quebec. I didn't really pay attention exactly where, but out of Quebec, but that's cool. That truck has ran more than once, probably 5 times, I think I read. He sent me a message. Last few times, the block has no water. He still says it runs good, so let's put a little video up of the motor running just recently. That doesn't sound too bad. Fuck, just get her bent, buddy. Bring her down, have some fun. It's all about wrecking her. He just wants to scrap it, yep. He says anyways. So yeah, hopefully you make it down, because more the merrier, right?
That's right.
That's right. Anybody else we're forgetting? There's Riley, Brian, Steve,
Hey guys, as you can tell, I'm editing up Tear It Up Tuesday. I forgot to mention another character that's going down to Tweed with a car in a full size. Be Devin Germain with that Dodge Magnum. Can't wait to see that run. Hey Devin, here's some pictures of it flying by. Sorry I forgot to mention it with Mike, but I remembered. So anyways, Devin, see you in Tweed.
Oh, here's another guy that might be bringing. He's on back and forth of what he's bringing down, but he sent us a startup video, so let's put it in there, guy to Smith Falls. What's his name?
Oh, Randy.
Randy. Let's just put
Time
that
to
startup.
Tear it up, get her bent.
Thanks, Randy. I hope you get that car down to Tweed. You do great when you get in the ring. You just send her. Have some fun with it. Let's get her bent. Speaking of Tweed, with the car, how many Winter Derbies you ever ran?
One.
Just the one? Just that one in Petawawa?
Just the one in Petawawa. I don't know how many years ago they tried it once, and
that's right,
that was the only one.
Just that one time, eh? That day that I was standing in the snowbank and I froze.
Yeah, was a cold day.
That was a cold day. What was that, a Dodge Caravelle or a K-car
thing?
Yeah,
it was a K-car or something, yeah.
Yeah, that was a cold day. That was way back. I don't even have a picture of that day.
I might have a picture of that car. If I find it, I'll share it.
Yeah, okay. If you find it. Oh, yeah, my winter derby experience was Sterling years ago with Impact. Drove all the way to Sterling on a cold fucking day. Mike towed me down. Get in the ring for less than 30 seconds.
One hit.
Thanks, Oliver. Thanks a lot. I really appreciate that. Anyways, anything else? Anything you looking forward to coming up in 2020, since I got you here?
Warm weather,
that's cool.
Just enjoying the derbies, going to some new ones. Some that you think that we should go to.
Yeah, I like
that. Check out some new ones.
I like that. Some new places for we can reach. If the derby ends up being a Saturday, it's very feasible to go, very plausible. Sundays, distance-wise, we can't go too far, right? You know, we got to work Monday. But Saturday, you know, we can always make it a late fucking night. You know what I mean? So that's cool.
We always try to make it, so,
yeah.
You know.
And I love going to places I've never been. It is what it is. Everybody likes it.
Same with me.
Yeah, exactly.
Meet new people, see what they run down there or wherever.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Exactly. And we're hoping to make it to Mini Meltdown, but it'll be a late-night drive because I'm burning holidays already.
Stay tuned.
That's feasible.
Well, either way, if you don't go, I will more than likely be there.
Thank you very much. I like that. If I don't make it down, we're gonna have a getter bent guy on the grounds. I really appreciate that. I want to go. I just have to arrive late Friday, but that's another soapbox.
It's not like we haven't done it before.
Exactly. But anyway, I think that's lots of information.
Yeah.
I think that's lots. Like I said, it's only beginning. It's only January, and we got a couple of winter derbies coming up. We're going to Tweed, like we said. We got a couple in the really earlier, Gravenhurst and Tanglesham. Derby season has begun. And of course, there's derbies going on in the States. There's something in Kentucky this weekend. Bluegrass or whatever.
No, but is there one that just happened, or is it happening, the Florida Nationals?
Thank you, yes. I said that last one. That's right. Thanks, Mike. Next weekend, free Derby, Trackshot TV, Derby USA, Trackshot TV for sure.
DerbyNation.com
or something. If I find the little picture, of course, I'll throw it up here. But again, free Derby in Florida, Southern Nationals. This year, they're changing venues. It's going to be inside because the last couple of years, the track has been really soft and it was really disappointing. There's a lot of horsepower and the people just suck.
Is a raffle car going to be at the Nationals?
That's right. There's going to be a raffle car there, so that'd be fun.
And it looks well built.
Oh, yeah. I think the Ciopas built that.
Yeah, it's well built.
I don't have my information correct, but I think the same.
If you find a picture, we'll shoot it up.
Yeah, we'll put that up there too. I like that. Yeah, we'll put a picture up of that. But yes, next Saturday, free Derby. Forgot about that. So Derby season has begun. It's year round now.
I think in the States, though, Southerner, it just never stops.
It just never stops.
Because they don't have to deal with
what we're looking at our window here. But yeah, it's continuous. That's one thing with the Derby. It just keeps going and going. And you can't attend them all, but you can definitely welcome the internet. You can see them all.
Yeah, you can still scratch that little itch.
Yeah, exactly. Anyways, everybody, thanks a lot. Tear it up.
And get her bent.